this constantly changing world, life and personal values can seem more than a little unstable. Just when you think you have it all figured out, then everything changes. Sometimes life can seem overwhelming. Well, the good news is you can change your life. You have within you the power to learn how to flow with the changes and smooth out the bumps of life. You can experience the joy, peace, health, and abundance you deserve. You were created to be happy and productive. That urge to grow and express yourself was put there for a reason. Learn the spiritual principles that can help you not just to survive, but thrive in this changing world. At Unity, we'd like to help you do just that.
Imagine a spiritual path that honors the universal truths in all religions, that sees we are all one. Imagine a movement that respects each person's right to choose their spiritual path. Imagine a spiritual movement that empowers and unites rather than divides. This is Unity. For more than a century, Unity has offered a positive, practical, and progressive approach to understanding and applying the teachings of Jesus and other spiritual masters.
Welcome to October, where the spiritual mind power is zeal. Zeal is the enthusiasm or the mighty force behind all things in the universe. Zeal is eagerness. It is an ardent interest in the pursuit of something. When I have a task ahead, I call on my zeal to adjust my mood. After adjustment, I am eager to engage. When my desire to accomplish is spiced up with zeal, I become excited and highly motivated. I am ready to go. Zeal is intensity. It is the inward fire of the soul that urges man onward. Zeal is the affirmative impulse of existence. Its command is to go forward. When in manifestation mode, I call forth my zeal. It always intensifies my focus and conviction. It keeps me on task. My zeal is the catalyst that ignites the fire within. That fire burns brightly and lights my way. Onward, I then go. When deciding a course of action, if my zeal begins to build, it is an indication to me that I am on the right track. When I feel the zeal, I know I'm in motion. Ever forward, I go. Let's take a minute and turn within. In the silence, let us individually feel our zeal. Zeal is fervor. Zeal is passion. Zeal is devotion. Zeal is the feel of strong excitement. Your zeal is the energy that promotes you. It speaks to your satisfaction with yourself. Your zeal is a direct connection that reflects your success, your fulfillment, your fortune. Wear it on your sleeve. It is a mirror of your love for yourself. If zeal's in the deal is real, and so it shall forever be.
Well, 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 good morning, good afternoon, good day, wherever you are, whatever you are, good day, God day, and welcome, welcome, welcome to Unity of Chicago South, Beyond Walls Ministry, spiritual community we are. First of all, before we go any further, I'd like to let you know that I am Reverend R. Ken Turner, minister here at Unity of Chicago South Online Ministry, Beyond Walls Ministry, and I want to thank you, Reverend Bobby, for such a dynamic intro into this month's spiritual practice of enthusiasm and zeal. This is first Sunday here at Unity of Chicago South, and as we do together, a poem submitted in January of 2016, the author is unknown. Who is it that found my wandering heart? This heart that leads me astray. A wanderer whom darkness falls. Memories of one who calls to the loss. The makers, the markers along the way. Road signs that simply say, I am here, come this way. Ignorant and ignoring the signs so many times, yet I find you're still here, pointing the way. In my myopia, looking for a utopia that I would never find. You patiently waited to remind me what I already knew in my heart. I am not alone. There is one who walks with me, one who is faithful and loves me. You have shown me the truth. Sunny days or stormy weather, only one thing matters. You and I together. You and I together. How many times must we be reminded that there is that within us that connects us to all that there is? A connection that is spoken of in Scripture, in 1 Kings, we have the story of God's revelation to Elijah, where Elijah stands on the mountain before the Lord, and a strong wind comes as the Lord passes by, the story goes on to say, and this great strong wind, it tore into the mountains and it broke the rocks, so it goes. It broke them into pieces before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. And after the earthquake, a fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire, a still small voice. And when Elijah heard it, he wrapped his face, it says, in his cloak and went out and stood at the entrance of the cave. And behold, there came a voice to him and said, what are you doing here? Old Testament, Hebrew Bible. Then in the Jesus portion of the Bible in Luke 17:21, talking about the kingdom of God, Jesus is saying something to the people, and he's letting them know through these words, neither shall they say, lo here, or lo there, for behold, the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is within you. And to go on to paraphrase Emily Cady, the author of Lessons in Truth, to educate is to bring forth that which is within. Ernest Holmes says this about the kingdom of God. This kingdom is an interior perception, not an external viewpoint. It is not external, but inner. The kingdom of God is within you. Are we getting the gist of today's meditation? The spiritual practice known as divine science, first taught by Belinda Kramer, teaches we are all sacred beings made in the image and likeness of our Creator, who is continually present everywhere, including within us. And then finally, in the Revealing Word, Charles Fillmore's work, he speaks of the kingdom within as the realm in human consciousness where we know and understand God. So my question today becomes, why do some of us spend so much time seeking that divine presence outside of ourselves? There can be so many answers. It can be answered in so many ways. But today's special guided meditation focuses on the inner search for that divine connection that already is, not to be made, not to be created, but to be allowed to expand into our life experience. Today, we are adapting some of Emma Curtis Hopkins' writings. And they're from a piece that is titled True Relations with Your Own Eternal Self and Practice of It. And then we're going to combine those thoughts and words with a scientific process where you asked internal questions and allow the indwelling presence to provide a path of solution or answers. Right now, this is not a time to take notes. So if you take notes, if you're used to taking notes, put your pens down. Because this is a time of spiritual participation. Some of you will say, but I want to have these questions that you're going to ask so that I can practice them during the week or later on, because this is a practicing spiritual practice. And you are correct. And if we did not give you tools to practice with, we would not be fulfilling the mission of providing a practical spiritual practice. But for today's guided meditation, you will find a PDF copy of the questions that we use in this guided meditation, and they will be available. They are right now available for download on our website's Meta Download page. And that's at unityocs.org. Let me say that again, unityocs.org. That's the only note you need to take today. That's it. And then go to Meta Downloads and you will see it there. Words from Emma Curtis Hopkins. She says, bear these words in mind. There is no balm from Gideon that can heal you of sorrow like these words can heal. There is no light like the light they can bring. So let us take that consciousness and prepare to receive that which is already within us, waiting to come forth into our life experience. Relax. Relax your shoulders. Relax your hips. Relax your legs. Relax your feet. Relax your neck. Make loose your body. As loose as you can be. And now let us begin our cleansing breaths. Breathe in. Hold it. Release. Breathe in. Hold it. Release. And one more. Breathe in. Hold it. Release. Know that in this place, at this time, we are open and continue to open to that which the prophets, the master teacher, and the practitioners of this spiritual movement have taught. We are connected to the divine allness. We are connected to the divine allness. As I speak these words, I speak them for all. As our self-questioning begins. How good is my God? How good is my God? Now relax, and whatever that goodness is, just relax in the goodness of your God. How present is its omnipresence? How present is its omnipresence? Yes. How powerful is its omnipotence? How powerful is its omnipotence? How knowing is its omniscient? How knowing is its omniscient? And why is my life in my God so good? Rest. Rest. Breathe. Release. Rest. How is my good expressing its truth? How is my good expressing its truth? Why is my good expressing its love? Why is my good expressing and love as love? In what way is my good expressing as substance? In what way is my good expressing as substance? Rest in the good. Rest in the God is your good. Rest is in your good is your God. In what way am I expressing my own idea of God as my life? In what way am I expressing my own idea of God in my life? Breathe. Breathe. How am I living, moving, and having my being according to my idea of God? Relax. Relax. How am I reflecting wisdom, strength, holiness in the oneness of spirit mind like my God? Rest, strength, holiness, rest. What way does my God work through me to will and to do whatever ought to be done by me? How does God, my God, work through me to guide me, to lift me, to provide strength for me, to do what I must do? Breathe that in. Release it. Relax. As I am governed by my God, why am I guided away from sin? Why am I guided away from the suffering for sin? Why am I guided away from the fear of sickness or sin? Breathe. Release. Relax. As we move into the finale, take another cleansing breath. Deep, deep, deep. Hold it. Release. Ask yourself that inner guidance, that inner guide, that inner threshold to the oneness. In what way am I beloved? In what way am I beloved? How am I expressing my peace with the world? How am I expressing my peace with the world? Hold that peace. Relax into that peace. Breathe into that peace. And now embrace that peace. Relax. Now as we begin to come back to this moment, in this place, we come back with the energy of our inner divine awakened and ready to express its fullness in our life, in our affairs, in our world, or in the law of our life. Yes. Yes. Okay, I want you to remember that you can download, that you may download the questions that were asked in this guided meditation. Just go to our website, unityocs.org, and go to Meta Downloads, and you'll see a PDF with all the questions there. I want to thank you so much for your consciousness today. And to say to you, until next time, this is Reverend R. Ken, and I bid you namaste.